right here right now.
Yeah.
Thank you. might all Christians sing to hear the news the angels bring.
On Christmas night, all Christians sing to hear the news the angels bring.
News of great joy, news of great good,
news of our merciful King's birth.
Then why should we on earth be so sad, since our Redeemer made us glad?
Welcome to this FEL Sacred Christmas Concert, a concert that's become an annual tradition for many of us in the FEL family. To not distract from the dignity that we offer to our Christ Child, we'd ask that you would refrain from your applause until the end, when we can thank the choirs. A reading from Romans chapter 8. For the creation waits an eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. We know that the whole creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth right up to the present time. Not only so, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit grown inwardly, as we wait eagerly for our adoption to sonship, the redemption of our bodies. For in this hope we were saved. But hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what they already have? But if we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. This is the word of the Lord.
from Isaiah chapter 9.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. This is the word of the Lord.
In song rejoice and sing. Sing Hosanna, sing one and all. Let mankind praise his name and answer the call. Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Sing Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Sing Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Sound the pipe and drum all across the land. We stand united, hand in hand. Blessing, honor, glory to you. Let mankind praise his name and rejoice anew. Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Noel, Noel, sing Noel. Sing Noel.
Rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Give ye heed to what we say. Jesus Christ is born today. All shall us before him bow, and he is in the manger now. Christ is born today. Christ is born today. Christian man, rejoice
with heart and soul and voice.
Now ye hear of endless bliss. Jesus Christ was born for this. He hath opened the heavenly door, and man is blessed forevermore. Christ was born for this. Christ was born for this.
Christ was born to save,
calls you all to gain his everlasting home.
Christ was born to
Christ
save,
was born to
Christ
save,
was born to
Christ
save,
was born to
Christ
save.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
reading from Luke chapter 2. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from Micah chapter 5. But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor bears a son, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach the ends of the earth, and he will be our peace. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Luke, chapter 2. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angels, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." This is the word of the Lord.
reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 2. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. This is the word of the Lord.
Star led wise men on their way to find that A reading from Luke chapter 2. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. This is the word of the Lord.
Rejoice and be merry in songs and in mirth, for praise our Redeemer, all mortals on earth. For this is the birthday of Jesus our King, who brought us salvation. His praises, his praises we'll sing. Rejoice and be merry in songs and in mirth, for praise our Redeemer, all mortals on earth. This is the birthday of Jesus our King, who brought us salvation. His praises we'll sing.
A heavenly vision appeared in the sky, as numbers of angels the shepherds did spy,
proclaiming the birthday of Jesus our King, who brought us salvation. His praises, his praises we'll sing.
Likewise a bright star in the sky did appear, which led the wise men from the east to draw near.
Come the Messiah, sweet Jesus our King, who brought us salvation. His praises we'll sing.
Blessed forever be Jesus our King, who brought us salvation. His praises will sing, his praises, his praises will sing. Rejoice and be merry, rejoice and be merry, rejoice and be merry, rejoice and be
reading from Romans
chapter 5. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. You see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous man, though for a good person someone might possibly dare to die. But God demonstrated his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, he died for us. Since we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? For if, while we were God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his Son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life? This is the word of the Lord.
Peace on earth and good.
I knew you couldn't hold that in. During the course of this program, seeing the work that these students have done, the directors, the accompanists, all you can see just the amazing talent that they have. And there were so many times during those songs, especially the Pick Me Up ones, that you just wanted to just jump up and clap and shout as the words, and the Holy Spirit working through the word guides us and leads us. So once again, I think we need to do even a better job of acknowledging what these people have done, and let's thank them one more time. Student, Mr. Josh Mose, who is kind of this farewell performance. So thank you very much for your work here. And on behalf of the faculty and staff and the students, we'd like to wish all of you the Lord's blessings this Christmas season. Have a safe trip home.